Yeah, start up.
Yeah. is it to keep them on track?
It's very important. If he could, he would sit behind or in front of a PlayStation 3. A Sony PlayStation, of course, because it's hard when you reach to the higher levels. It's hard. You lose a lot of fights, you win a lot of matches, and maybe disappointment and happiness when you win the tournament, of course, but already as 10 years old to be beaten. You can see at some tournaments the young boys and girls, they're crying and shouting at the parents, but you must go through it if you want to the top level. It's very important. But the next week they have for the young, this is small boys and girls, but next week they have for the adult, 15, 17, 18 years old. They are extremely good. They offer, spend all their free time on badminton. And I don't know if that's a good idea. But if you have a great talent, it's okay. You need to spend all your time. And the clubs in Denmark are telling that to the young people, that if you want to be an elite player, you cannot sit in front of a PlayStation 3. You must every day work to be better. But as a parent, I try to divide it a little bit. Because they're not. If you press too hard, they stop at when they're 14 years old. They don't want anymore. Because you have taught them that you want to be an E player, and maybe if you're 15, you're only an A player. Then they stop. It's important to let them take the steps. But the clubs, of course, press on to find the elite players. So it's a balance, you know.
It's very interesting. If badminton comes to your mind, what is the picture or the
My picture is a lot of fun, but that's, you know, I never look into it, I never see it in television and so on.
Okay.
Games, I do not watch it.
Mm-hmm. So, are you proud of badminton? I mean, in a way, or is it something you?
Yes. I think I am. It's a very, very fair sport. And not rough, and you. You have to use your whole body when you play badminton. It's a very healthy sport.
Mm-hmm. Why so many outstanding players in Denmark?
But that's due to the history. It's due to the very good work done by the clubs. As I mentioned before, that there are clubs almost anywhere, that there are halls almost anywhere in the country. I think actually it's also an advantage that we are a small country, so it's very easy to organize tournaments. Danish players are very used to competing, much more than other European players, I think. From a very young age they compete in team matches against other local clubs and then district clubs and then on a nationwide basis they play individual tournaments. So it's very easy to get a lot of matches against other players that you don't know.
On your wrist, and should be over your shoulder.
Mm.
If there's a mirror to the side of you, you should look in that mirror and see that the racket has not passed your head, means you have not hit it in front of you in that movement. Mm. That is how you correct yourself, and then you can stand in front of a mirror and do this like.
So, This is how you can remember it.
Mm. And it's always to do the same.
Yes, everything is the same. Yeah. If you lob a little shot, oh, you make a little more speed. No, oh, you can remember this. This is here. It's difficult to remember. Too long.
A lot of capillaries, and we compared the right leg with the left leg. And it was really surprising to find that there was quite a difference between the two legs, because when you are right-handed, you work with the right leg, and so the circumference of the leg and the calves was bigger than the left. The area of the muscle fibers was the same, and actual there was also in the percentage of fibers a difference between the right leg and the left leg. So many years training might be the reason for that, that they had been working with half
a football player, or you just do that every day or every week with your
friends?
Just
do it, yeah. Like, every day almost.
Okay.
A lot of my friends play badminton.
Okay.
You know Janne Jørgensen? Best Danish guy.
Yes, I saw it.
I know him.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I saw him today play. He's in the preparation for the World Cup series in China.
Yeah.
Exactly. What does
badminton
mean to you? I mean,
well, Denmark is a pretty big nation. What goes to badminton? So I think if you would ask people in Denmark what they thought about badminton, they wouldn't say, "What the fuck do I care?" They would say, "We will always wait for the Olympics, as that is the greatest competition for badminton players."
Okay.
And I believe that's pretty much all it's about for the common Danish people. Like, we don't care about World Cup or European Cup, or
we care if we win.
Okay, just
But it's really not that big until it hits the Olympics. Then it's really big, because Denmark is, I mean, we don't have so many disciplines to compete in, but badminton is always one of them. So,
is it easy to play badminton somewhere? I mean, you have a lot of halls.
Yeah.
A lot of buildings.
Because because all the places where you can play handball, you can also play badminton. So this is common. You have this kind of combination also.
From our last interview, I make the heading is I will always be an emotional person. You still agree to that?
Yeah, indeed. You know, I try to use it as a strength. You know, sometimes it can turn into a weakness if things aren't really going as you hope for on court. So I try to use it as an motivation and a way of you know, expressing my love to the game. And you know, when things are going really well, you know, it's good to show some emotions, I think, and it also makes it more interesting for the spectators to watch. Mm. So I will always try to show my emotions, and you know, even though sometimes you get a few yellow cards or warnings and stuff, you know, I take that with, because I'm not gonna change who I am because of some yellow cards or some warnings. You know, I will have myself in the game all the time. And
okay.
The bigger clubs, the more they can offer the players. Mm. So that means a lot. Like under, you know, you start at a level in Denmark. There are many clubs, but I think there are about 400 or 500 clubs in Denmark. And then if you start in a small club and you're good, you move to a bigger club. Mm. Because they can offer you more.
Okay, and Camilla Martin?
Yeah. We have gone in the same school.
Okay.
Yeah.
You?
Yeah.
Really?
Yes.
Amazing.
Yeah, in high school.
Okay.
Yeah.
You still have connect?
What is your name and how old are
you? 14.
You're 14 years old. What is your name?
Sophie. Yeah.
Sophie what?
Nielsen.
Yeah. Okay. And you told me that you do every, you're in a good place to train with Peter Gale.
Yeah.
And when did it start?
Yeah. I've called competing with him in practice for a very long time, and I'm quite tired of it now, so I'm looking forward to playing some matches in China, so yeah, it'll be good fun.
And you were also happy when it started?
Maybe, it depends on the result. If the result is good, I'm happy it started. If it's not, then I just want a new World Championship very soon.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Yeah. what I might do. Do just what I had to be. What I heard you say, what you said to me. But baby, do inside. Look like you're working up an appetite. For the night, dig it. By then, I just sat at the back. Keeping you out. The way you drag it, straight to that. Getting out of line, I'm taking you back. In your place.
I knew just what it had to be.